This particular video is basically to give you 100 days to CAT plan. So if you're starting from scratch, so a basic plan for preparation with regards to the exam. So 100 days is less to some extent, yes. But yes, I've seen people doing their best and getting their best potential in 100 days. So my suggestion is if you're planning to write your CAT this year, give your best efforts and try to do your best. That should help you, right? So there are two plans that I go about when you're starting a little bit late, like now. Okay, you can broadly plan it in two ways. One is complete your syllabus in 40 days. So first step, 40 days, start with your syllabus, complete your syllabus. And then last 60 days, focus on mocks, revision and improvement. So the second stage is important. Don't ignore this. So in briefly complete a syllabus and then focus on revision and improvement. The second plan is take 47 days. But during that 47 days, spend 7 days in between where you write a mock. So every week, once a week, write a mock. Okay, so you know where you stand, you know, when you're preparing, and accordingly you can make modification in your preparation and then accordingly go about it. So either of the two plans. Okay, and the rest 53 days for mocks, revision, improvement. Now normally the first plan would be for people who are not really comfortable with the fundamentals and basic, or really, really starting from scratch. So for them, it makes sense to once go through the syllabus so that they know what the syllabus is and then prepare. For second, who feel their fundamentals are okay, I mean, not good, but okay, and they feel that they can write a mock, and then maybe they can write a mock once every week to know where they stand, and then accordingly may modify their preparation to whichever you're comfortable. I mean, choose a plan. It could be something in between. So maybe you may write three or four mocks in between. So every 2 weeks you may write one mock, or every 3 weeks you may write one mock, just to know where you stand preparation. So that could always be done. So modify your plan based on what your comfort level is and how do you go forward. So let's start with CAT sections. So we know there are three sections in CAT: quant, DLR and verbal, right? 34 questions, 32 questions, 34 questions, total 100 questions, which amount to 300 marks. So we look at each section and look at how to go about preparing for the same. So normally I would recommend to start with a mock, because it makes sense to know which exam and what type of exam you're giving. Okay, so one, it helps you to understand the pattern of the paper, like what type of question comes. For example, in DI there are a lot of different type of questions which come, okay, in different examination. But the way the questions come in the CAT is quite different from the other examinations. So before you pick up a book, it makes sense to just glance through and see, understand the paper pattern. Same with verbal. There is a lot of grammar in books. There is a lot of vocabulary in book. But in the exam, there is no grammar and verbal. Grammar and vocabulary. So why focus on that while preparing? So once you know, wrote, write, mock, you understand the paper pattern, you can accordingly know what could be important and what may not be important, and accordingly plan your preparation. One more thing it helps writing a mock is to know which areas are weak of yours and which areas are strong. So normally it makes sense to focus a little bit more on your weak area so that you can improve your weak area, right? Because some of the colleges do have sectional cutoffs. So if you can just clear the cutoffs, that will help you to get a call from the colleges. So focus more on the weak areas during preparation. That's important. So preparation time, how much time is required per day? So minimum 5 hours to maximum 7 hours a day is what is required. Maximum 7 hours, I put a cap, because more than that you get saturated and then, you know, studying too much may not help. You can stretch, but I would recommend that 5 to 7 hours is sufficient as far as the day is concerned. You are a best judge in terms of your own plan. See, ensure that you don't saturate yourself. Ensure that when you're preparing, you mix your day with a lot of, I mean, some gaps in between. So you can, maybe do some hobby like painting in between, or something that you like in between, so that your mind remains fresh, right? Tentative breakup of the whole plan is maybe quant for 2 to 4 hours, depending on your comfort level. So if you feel you're good at strong at quant, you can only do for 2 hours. But if you feel you're weak at quant, spend a little bit more time on quants, maybe 4 hours, right? Same with DLR, maybe 1 to 1.5 hours. So DLR is important, though we feel that DLR is not so much as a syllabus. But the DLR that comes in the examination is a little different. So being comfortable with them helps. So spend at least 1 hour on the DLR section. Take a few questions and try to solve. That helps. Reading is the most important thing for CAT. Reading not only helps you for your verbal section, but may help you for your content and DILA section as well. So spend at least one time hour on reading. What you read, we'll come back to it. But yes, read is very important. Puzzles for half an hour, something like Sudoku Kakuro, and mental calculation for 15 minutes. This is what a breakup generally is for that 5 to 7 hours of day of preparation. So let's now look at each section wise and see how do you go about preparing per section. So normally the con section, the syllabus which is there is school level syllabus. Nothing much beyond that, school level. So technically, even if you write the examination right on mock, and if you slightly remember your school level mathematics, still write the paper. So you may still get answers to quite a few questions in that case. So anyway, in the actual exam also, a lot of people don't solve too many questions. You have to only pick up the easy questions and solve, which you can do now also. Try doing that. Okay, we spend a lot of time of our preparation on quant because the syllabus of quant is huge. There are 20 odd topics on quant, and therefore, since the syllabus is huge, to getting familiar and remembering all that, you know, concepts and theory in quant, it takes time. So therefore, more time is normally spent on quant. Okay, what is important is that you get fundamentals right and solve a few sums. Don't do a mistake of trying to solve too many sums or too many questions as such. Just solve a few sums right now because you have to complete the syllabus on time. Remember that. If you don't complete the syllabus on time, you may not be able to get to the second level, and then you may not be able to, you know, be well prepared for the exam. You can always come back to a topic when you're in the second stage. That means when you're writing a mock and you feel that one topic I'm not comfortable with, you can always come back. But for right now, ensure that you're just fundamentally clear and you can solve a few sums in a particular section, because that's the way that sums are asked in the exam. They're based on fundamentals, and but makes you think. That's what's important. You need not go to tough sums in the stage. In the exam also, the focus is obviously to pick up the easy sums and solve. So you can, if you want to solve tough sums, you can look at later stage. Right now, focus on easier sums or medium level sums. If you have time, you feel, then try to look at alternate approaches for the easy medium sums. That will help you more than trying to focus on tough sums, because tough sums will take you a longer time. Not only longer time, but that will ensure that you don't get enough practice for a question that you are solving. Focus on getting alternate method, as I said. What helps more is trying to get different methods for the same sum than solving tougher sums. So if you have an easy sum, you have solved a sum, go back and check, can I use the options for solving? Can I have any other way of solving? That could help you better. The common mistakes that people do while preparing for con section. They spend too much time on con section. But this is, I mean, right now, considering that you're in the last 100 days to CAT, you cannot do this mistake. I mean, if you had 1 year left and you spent too much time on topic, it was fine. But now you cannot spend that much time. So ensure that you don't spend too much time on one topic. Because if you spend too much time on one specific topic, then you'll get less time on the other topic. Just to give you an example, normally the first topic that comes is number system, which is very fast. But let me tell you, most of the subtopics in number system don't even come in the exam. So people end up wasting a lot of time on that one topic which is there. And then they realize, oh, I've spent so much time on a topic which is not important. Now I don't have time for topic which are important. So ensure that you just go to spend some time on each section. That should help you better. Focus on quantity is a mistake. People see, I will solve 100 sums and that is better. No. It is important that you solve few sums and try to get maybe better methods for the same sum. I'm not saying spend a lot of time on a sum, but solve a sum, understand a sum, and see if you can get better method, then go to next sum. The quality is more important than quantity. Don't focus that if I solve 100 sums, I'll be better in solving someone else. No, that doesn't happen in CAT. It may happen under exam where, you know, your rote learning helps, but CAT is more of thinking based exam. It's more important you understand the concepts than maybe focus on trying to mug up the concepts and solve too many questions. Don't spend too much time. People do spend. I mean, I have people come back and say, oh, I couldn't get a sum. I spent half an hour on the sum. Why did you spend half an hour on the sum? Doesn't make sense. You wasted half an hour of your time where you could have solved more sums and practiced more sums at that time. Same with maybe DILA sets where people spend hours and hours on one set. Doesn't make sense. So ensure that you don't spend too much time. You don't get a sum in your, obviously you have to start with thinking on your own. That's very important. No, don't look at the answers every time. First step is always think on your own. If you don't get the answer in some time, go back to the solutions. But at least spend some time on thinking on your own, but not too much of time. practice and solve concepts that are not. So people again waste time on this. So there are a lot of concepts which are not important for CAT, like remainder theorems, binomial theorem, Bayes system, trigonometry formulas. And these are tough concepts which takes a lot of time to prepare. And when people prepare on this, it is just, wastage of time. So there are a lot of concepts in maybe functions chapter, there are a lot of concepts in permutation combination chapter, which don't come in the exam, which are too complicated and not required. So ensure that you don't get into too much of theory and too much of theorems, which were not in your school. Let me put it this way. Your syllabus is school level, focus on what is there in the school level and work on that. Anyway, when you solo mock, you'll have a fair idea as to what type of questions come. Broad schedule on to how to prepare, finish your con section in 40. So try not to give too much time on any particular topic. I given 3 days in time to distance because there are a lot of variations in time to distance, but every other topic 1 or 2 days. For example, if I'm looking at profit and loss, I'm sure you're a little bit comfortable with theory of profit and loss. Just take a few sums, solve, and just be comfortable with it. So that means if I'm spending 3 hours a day or 4 hours a day, I may be able to solve 20 sums a day. That should suffice as far as preparation goes. Go a little theory, solve 20-25 sums on a topic. I think some topics where you may have to go in depth to understand, maybe there you can spend some time. Maybe geometry is a little bit more theory, you can spend more time on geometry. Okay. PNC has more concepts, if I've given 3 days on that. So you can just go through those topics, understand maybe in depth. You can vary this according to your comfort level. But yeah, this is a tentative breakup. This is also to tell you that not to spend too much time on a topic. You can't afford saying that I start with number system, I spend 5 days on number system. 2 days. How much ever you have done, do that and go to next topic straight away. And if you realize a lot of these topics you may be comfortable with already, like averages, percentage, profit and loss, you've done in your school, so you know it. So out there, don't take too much time, take lesser time, take more time on topics which are not comfortable. DILA section. Now the issue with DILA section in the CAT is the questions are quite varied. And you don't have books that have all the type of questions that are there for DILA. Okay, it is normally that comes in the exam is non-traditional type. Either they try to merge two different type of sums and make into one set or have a very different type of sets. The first step I would say is try to focus on getting familiar with the normal traditional type of questions. What normally is there, try to do that. And then try to go into that mixed sums which normally come in the exam. One more thing that helps is your puzzle solving. The moment you solve puzzles, it helps you to think and helps you to do better in the exam because it's all about thinking in the examination. It's not a traditional type of question. Puzzle solving will help you for the non-traditional type of questions. What should be your daily plan? 1 to 1.5 of DILR is what is expected. 15 minutes multiple. This definitely will help you in mathematics as well as DILR. Okay. Take a few sums and just calculate mentally, like multiply it. Simple two-digit numbers will also do. Multiply it, divide it, factorize it, other things as such. Try doing it mentally, simple mental calculation, because a lot of time is wasted in the exam purely in calculation. Do I understand calculators are given to you, at least in a CAT examination? But being comfortable with mental calculation definitely helps. Also spend some time on puzzle because it helps you to think. Depending on your time available, you can spend 15 minutes to 45 minutes on puzzles. What type of puzzles? It is common Sudoku, Kakuro, Hirato. There are apps on this. You can pick up those puzzles and solve. Right? Newspapers have these puzzles. You can pick up any puzzles from the internet. Go on the net, search for logical puzzles and try to get puzzles from there. Or you can pick up puzzles from books like Shakuntala Devi, George Summers, etc. Okay, these are different puzzles that will help you keep your mind ticking and help you to maybe in your DILR as well as con section. Syllabus, try to complete your DILR syllabus in 30 days, not too much, because whatever you're doing from the books will never come in the exam. It just gives you the basics for helping you to do further. So not more than 30 days is what I recommend. So normally is understand the basic DI types and LR types. Okay, that's what is important in the syllabus time. First of all, easy sums don't need to solve tough sums. You can solve tough sums when you're doing after 30 days, when you're picking up sums from the mocks, etc. Then you can solve. Right now, focus on easy sums. Okay, ensure that you keep that. Again, this is just to comfortable for your basics. So even if you pick up a few sets and solve, that should be sufficient. Don't try to solve all sums from the chapter. It's a waste of time in that case. Common mistake, too much focus on books. In the initial stage, do the books to to complete a syllabus. But my suggestion is try to move away from the books as far as possible over a period of time. Okay, because good sums are normally not available in the books as far as CAT is concerned. CAT normally has mixed type of sums, and a good source of those preparation is mocks. But just do that after you finish once going to the basic syllabus of DILR section. Right. Too much time on a single set. As I said, people pick up a set logic set and keep trying to solve it till you get the answer. There's no point spending 1 hour on a set. I mean, you've wasted your time. You could have gone to maybe 2-3 sets at that time and been comfortable with different type of sets. Try to solve a sum, but try on your own. That's very important. Try to solve a sum. If you don't get it in 10-15 minutes, go look at the solution. It's perfectly all right. Understand it. Come back. Try to figure out what the solution is and understand the process. Briefly, the different type of questions that come in the exam. So when you say bar chart, pick up one day a few bar chart sums and solve just to get comfortable with the graphs. So these are DI sets and these are LR. You can maybe do one day LR, one day DI or so on, whichever you're comfortable with and how you want to do as such. I've given more time on logic because in the examination, the question that comes is more of logic type than of DI type. So spend more time on logic as far as possible. Verbal section, 24 out of 34 questions are RCs, 3 are parasemi. These 27 questions basically depends on reading. So that means most of your part of your verbal section is purely on reading, no grammar, no vocabulary. You can just ignore them right now, or you can do a little bit of grammar and vocabulary. But recommended is focus more on reading because that is what is going to help you in your CAT exam. Word sentence out and jumble para, they're there, right? Practice them separately. But there are 7 questions on that. From that, jumble para normally goes wrong. But it helps to practice jumble para because it helps you in odd sentence out. So two areas that you need to prepare on. One is jumble para, one is reading. But focus on reading because of most of your weightage and most of your marks will come from there. Preparation. Read. If you read regularly, that should help. My suggestion is, and what I feel is, reading is what will make you comfortable. Normally the articles that come in a newspaper, I've made a separate video on that. And normally the articles are from the international newspapers and magazine, like the New York Times, the Guardian, Economist, etc. So you can pick up from aldaily.com or some other source, Aeon, etc. and read those articles. It helps. So you can go to the video which I put about where the RC passages come from the last 3-4 years, and you will understand the source. But if you're not comfortable with reading with that, first make a habit of reading. Pick up some easy books, novels, etc. and start making a habit of reading before you go into a high level reading practice. Writing blogs and personal diary also helps. If you have a time, do it. Just because it helps your language. So when you read, you get, you know, unconsciously you understand the language. And when you put it on paper, you become conscious about what you're writing, the formation of grammar, the language, etc. So it somewhere helps to write blogs, personal diary, etc. Read novels on your leisure time. So I told you 5 hours of preparation, 7 hours of the preparation. So in the leisure time, you can pick up something to read, something which you like reading, something on your hobby, something on your interest. So when I said 1 hour of reading, 1 hour of reading for CAT, but you can do beyond that, maybe more reading on something on your leisure on the topics that you like reading. It could help. The biggest mistake that people do in the CAT preparation as a whole is not reading regularly, because reading helps you in all areas, in English, in mathematics, in DILR. A lot of people just do mistakes in maths and DILR because they don't understand the language that is given out there. They're not habituated to reading. Ensure that you read regularly. It should help you throughout as far as CAT is concerned. Right? Fine. I hope this helps you to make a plan. As I said, broadly, 2 plans which are there. Either you can do mocks along with your syllabus, or you can do first syllabus and mocks, or mixture of the two. See what is comfortable to you and then accordingly prepare. Right? Not too much time, but enough time for you to crack the examination. So completely focus on your preparation. Go ahead with it. Believe in yourself. Don't worry about low scores. I'm sure you'll be able to do well in the exam. Thank you.